Dear friends, in the earlier module, we have discussed about the field equations and the propagation of electromagnetic waves of different modes through rectangular and circular waveguides. What will happen if the remaining two sides of the waveguide are closed? Definitely, it's a very interesting thing. Such waveguides with all the sides closed are called as cavities. And if the frequency is in the region of microwave, then the cavity is called as microwave cavity. Such microwave cavities have very important characteristics. They resemble the LCR circuit which we have studied in our undergraduate studies. In this module, let us discuss some important points about such cavities. One of the important characteristics is that of storage of electromagnetic energies. The cavities are able to store electromagnetic energy. It is very interesting to note or to study the aspect of conditions for storage of such electromagnetic energy by gravity, by a cavity. It depends upon the dimensions and many other factors associated with the cavity. Now, we have discussed various types of components. When the component they are coupled, we get a circuit, and in general we can have N port network. If we consider an N port network, which is two terminals input and two terminal output, then such a N port network, which can be supposed to be a black box, can be analyzed with the help of different types of parameters, H parameters, T parameters, etc. So, if you are having such microwave cavities or microwave devices, then how to model mathematically such cavities or such microwave devices? That is a very important thing, because here we cannot talk about the measurement of voltages or currents at the input and output terminals under open and short circuit conditions. We are playing with microwaves. So, what is the way out? So, we have to develop or study, we have to know about one important new type of parameters, which is called as S parameters, that is scattering parameters. And those parameters are highly useful for modeling such cavities. So, let us discuss some such points which are totally new to us in this module. After completing this module, you will be able to understand the concept and prominent features of microwave cavities. Secondly, you will be able to understand the mathematical aspects associated with cavity resonators. In addition, you will be able to know about the concept of Q factor of a cavity resonator and understand the need of S parameters. What is microwave cavity? A microwave cavity can be described as a completely enclosed metal structure which can confine the electromagnetic wave in the microwave region of the electromagnetic spectrum. The cavity can be hollow or filled with a dielectric. We have studied propagation of electromagnetic waves through rectangular and circular or cylindrical waveguides. If the open ends of the waveguides are closed, then the electromagnetic wave will be confined within the waveguide. It cannot propagate beyond the boundaries of the waveguide. There arises standing wave in the cavity. Rather, due to multiple reflections from the boundary of the waveguides, it exhibits the properties of resonance. Hence, they are called as resonant cavities. An electromagnetic wave carries electric and magnetic energy, which is stored in the cavity. We know that the device having ability to store electric energy has capacitance, while the one having ability to store magnetic energy has inductance. Thus, the microwave cavity possesses an equivalent capacitance and an equivalent inductance. The metallic cavities of the wall can cause dissipation of power due to their finite conductivity. Thus, we understand that a cavity is equivalent to a combination of an inductor, a capacitor, and a resistor. We are familiar with the terms resonance, resonant frequency, quality factor, bandwidth, etc. associated with LCR circuits. The same concepts equally apply for microwave cavities. Rectangular, circular, and re-entrant cavity resonators are generally used in most of the microwave applications. Microwave cavities can be mathematically analyzed using Maxwell's equations and the norms of field theory. However, the properties are similar to that of LCR series circuit. It has a resonant frequency, which is the characteristic frequency depending upon the intrinsic or geometric parameters of the waveguide for a given mode of electromagnetic wave. The energy stored by the microwave cavity can also be utilized for several applications. Maximum energy can be delivered if certain conditions are satisfied. Mathematical analysis of cavity resonators reveals the fact of existence of infinite number of resonant modes for a given cavity. Each of these modes has a definite resonant frequency. When the external frequency, which is also called as impressed frequency, matches with any of these resonant frequencies, the amplitude of the corresponding standing wave becomes maximum, resulting in equal storage of peak amount of electric and magnetic energy. The mode having lowest resonant frequency is known as the dominant mode. We can derive the expression for resonant frequency of a cavity using Maxwell's equations incorporating proper boundary conditions. We have seen that for propagation of electromagnetic wave through a waveguide, we have to deal with the general solution of the Helmholtz differential equation del square psi is equal to gamma square psi, where psi represents appropriate component of E or H fields depending upon the mode, such as TE or TM. For example, for propagation of TE mode through a rectangular waveguide along positive direction of z-axis, we have psi is equal to HZ. For propagation of TM mode through a rectangular waveguide along positive direction of z-axis, we have psi is equal to EZ. We also note that gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta is the propagation constant of the waveguide, wherein alpha, which is known as attenuation constant, corresponds to the loss of power during propagation, while beta represents the propagation constant. In the case of a lossless dielectric, alpha is equal to 0. We have discussed about the field equations using Maxwell's equations in the case of rectangular and circular waveguides with adequate mathematical details. Let us see how these solutions get modified when the waveguide is converted into a cavity. Consider a lossless rectangular waveguide of width A and height B as shown, through which a TE wave is propagating along the positive direction of z-axis. From the discussion in earlier modules, we know the differential equation and its solution satisfying the boundary conditions for such a waveguide, which are as shown. What will be the solution if the waveguide is closed along z-axis at a distance d? See the rectangular cavity so formed of length d, breadth a, and height b as shown. Again, as before, we have to apply the boundary conditions of tangential components of E being same, which is equal to 0 at the boundary, that is at z equal to 0 and z equal to d. It can be shown mathematically that with the application of the boundary conditions, the solution comprises of a product of three harmonic functions as shown. Here, m, n, and p are positive integers having values as shown. Note that p is a non-zero integer. Note that here m, n, p represents the number of half wave periodicities, that is number of half oscillations in x, y and z direction respectively. The mode is designated as TEMNP. For a given set of values of guide dimensions A, B and D, we can plot the field patterns corresponding to a desired set of integers M, N and P. We are familiar with the relation KC square is equal to omega squared mu epsilon minus beta G square. In a cavity, there are standing waves only. No progression of electromagnetic wave implies beta G equal to 0. Hence, we have KC squared is equal to omega squared mu epsilon. Thus, KC and K have the same expression. Now, let us see how to obtain the resonant frequency of the cavity. We know that for a lossless medium, K squared is equal to omega squared mu epsilon. Also, K squared is equal to kx square plus ky square plus kz square, where kx, ky, kz are as shown. Hence, k square finally reduces to under root of my upon a bracket square plus ny upon b bracket square plus py upon d bracket square. Now, k is equal to 2 pi upon lambda. Lambda is equal to 2 pi upon k, which is equal to v upon f. Hence, f is equal to kv upon 2 pi. Similarly, the velocity is equal to 1 upon under root of mu epsilon. With this, we get f is equal to k upon 2 pi under root mu epsilon. Substituting the expression for k referred earlier in terms of mode numbers m and p, we obtain the desired expression for resonant frequency of the rectangular cavity for TEMNP mode as shown. It is worth noting that the expression for resonant frequency of a rectangular type for TEMNP and TMMNP are same. Dominant mode is the mode with lowest resonant frequency. From the expression for FR, one can understand that if A and D are greater than B, then M is equal to 1, N is equal to 0 and P equal to 1 will give the smallest value of FR. Hence, the dominant mode is TE101 with guide dimensions AD greater than B. Similar to the waveguides, a desired mode can be excited in a rectangular waveguide by using a pair of single wire probe and a loop coupling. The single wire probe is inserted at the position of maximum electric field intensity, while the loop coupling is located at the position of maximum magnetic field intensity. We should remember that maximum amplitude of the standing wave occurs when the frequency of the impressed signal matches with the resonant frequency. As an example, have a look at the schematic diagrams of the excitation of such modes in a rectangular waveguide. After understanding the concept of cavity resonator and some important mathematical aspects associated with a rectangular cavity, let us discuss in brief similar points related with circular cavity resonator. A circular waveguide becomes a cavity resonator when its two circular open ends are closed by perfectly conducting metal. Consider a circular cavity of radius A and length or height D. Obviously, we have to use cylindrical coordinate system. Let us consider a TE wave. In the earlier module, we have derived the expressions for field components in the case of TE wave propagating along the positive direction of z-axis through a cylindrical waveguide. The expression for Hz is as shown. When the waveguide is converted into a cavity by closing its two circular ends by perfectly conducting metal, the E and H fields must satisfy the boundary condition at z equal to 0 and at z equal to d. With this, the expression for Hz becomes as shown. The meaning of different quantities involved in the expression is as shown. It is interesting to note the difference in the expression for Ez in the case of TM wave and that for Hz in the case of TE wave. the expressions are as shown. The expression for Hz involves the zeros of derivatives of Bessel function of first kind, while the expression for Ez does not involve the derivatives of Bessel functions. Rather, it involves only the zeros of Bessel function of first kind. The expression for resonant frequency for TENPQ and TMNPQ can be obtained mathematically, which are as shown. Note that the three integers, namely N, P and Q, characterize the TE and TM modes. From these expressions, the dominant modes which correspond to lowest resonant frequency can be obtained by noting the geometrical conditions of the cavity. For example, note the dominant modes shown for two different geometrical conditions, one for 2a greater than d and the other one for 2a less than d. We can have a semicircular cavity resonator as well. For example, observe the semicircular cavity resonators as shown. The expressions for resonant frequency for TE and TM modes are the same as in the case of circular cavity resonators, which involves zeros of Bessel function of first kind or its derivative. It be noted, however, that the values of integers N, P and Q in semicircular cavity resonator differ from that in circular cavity resonator. The geometry of the semicircular cavity determines dominant modes for TE and TM modes as shown. For D greater than A, dominant mode is TE111, while for D less than A, dominant mode is TM110. In general, one should note that due to oscillatory nature of Bessel function of first kind or its derivative, infinite values of zeros exist. Hence, there are infinite numbers of resonant frequencies for a given mode in circular or semicircular cavity. The one with lowest value corresponding to dominant mode is of much more significance in majority of the practical applications. Well, friends, as mentioned in the beginning, microwave cavities are just like LCR series circuit, which you already studied in the undergraduate studies. Inductive properties, capacitive properties and resistive properties, they are little bit different from each other. L and C, these components, they can store electric and magnetic energy. Over a cycle of AC, there is no dissipation of power. On the other hand, resistance is related with the dissipation of power. Thus, LCR resonant circuit or LCR circuit is associated with storage of electromagnetic energy as well as some loss of electrical or electromagnetic energy. Now, whether LCR circuit is able to store the energy to the larger extent or greater extent, that decides the quality of the LCR circuit. And one of the important point is regarding the resonance condition in LCR circuit. LCR circuit can store the electromagnetic energy at some particular frequency, which is called as resonant frequency of the LCR circuit. Can we not have such a resonant frequency with microwave cavity? The answer is definitely yes. But with a cavity, there are some losses, as we have seen in the earlier module, due to conducting walls and several other reasons. So, under what condition the microwave cavity can store large amount of energy with a minimum loss? That ratio is very important and is called as quality of the microwave cavity. So, let us discuss the definition and some other aspects associated with it. The cavity is said to be of better quality if it is able to store large amount of electromagnetic energy with a minimum loss of power. Accordingly, a quantity called as quality factor designated by letter Q is defined to account for the ratio of energy stored to the loss of power per cycle. Energy lost or stored are functions of frequency of the electromagnetic wave. Hence, the definition of Q involves the term per cycle. Thus, Q is also described as a measure of the frequency selectivity of a resonant circuit. In its mathematical form, Q is defined as shown, where W is the maximum energy stored and P is the average power loss. At resonance, the electric and magnetic energies share equally. Both energies are said to be in time quadrature. Accordingly, when the electric energy is maximum, the magnetic energy is minimum and vice versa. We know the expressions for energy density, that is energy per unit volume for electric and magnetic fields, which is as shown. Here E and H represent the peak values of the electric and magnetic field intensities respectively. The total electric energy WE and the total magnetic energy WM stored can be obtained mathematically by integrating the energy density over the volume V of the resonator. At resonance, the electric and magnetic energies are equal. Hence, in the expression Q is equal to omega W upon P, we have WE is equal to WM is equal to W. From the discussion in one of the earlier modules about propagation of plane waves in good conductors, we know that the average power density P is given by P is equal to 1/2 H square into RS, where RS is the surface resistance of the conductors. Using this expression, we can calculate the average power loss in the resonator by integrating the power density over the volume of the inner surface RS of the resonator, with H replaced by HT, which is the peak value of the tangential component of magnetic field intensity. Using these expressions for W and P, the quality factor Q of a cavity resonator can be approximately shown to be given by the expression as shown. As stated earlier, an isolated or unloaded cavity can be represented by a series or a parallel resonant circuit with equivalent L, C and R. The quality factor Q and the resonant frequency FR of such unloaded cavity resonator is given by the expressions FR as shown. It is very interesting to study what happens when such a cavity is connected to an external generator. Let us discuss some important points regarding such coupled cavity. Consider a cavity with unloaded quality factor Q0 to be coupled to a generator by means of an ideal transformer with a turn ratio N:1 and a series inductance LS as shown. Let VG and ZG be the voltage and impedance of the generator respectively. Obviously, after coupling, the quality factor of the cavity is affected. Let QL be the quality factor of the loaded cavity. We are familiar with the concept of equivalent electrical circuit. The equivalent electrical circuit of the cavity coupled to a generator using an ideal transformer under consideration is as shown. The equivalent circuit can be mathematically analyzed to obtain an expression for quality factor of the loaded cavity. In its simplest form, under certain conditions, the loaded quality factor QL of the cavity is approximately given by the expression as shown. The coupling coefficient K of the coupled system, which obviously involves the dissipative elements on two sides of the coupling, is given by the expression as shown. With this value of K, we can write the expression for QL in different forms as shown. Note that for a given cavity and generator, the number of turns affects K, which in turn affect the deviation of QL from Q0. In physics, While studying differential equations related with damped oscillations, we use three terms, namely critically damped, overdamped, and underdamped. On similar lines, we have three types of couplings in the case of coupled cavity under consideration. Those are critical coupling, overcoupling, and undercoupling. In critical coupling, the cavity resonator is perfectly matched with the generator, making k equal to 1. In this case, the three values of q are related with each other as shown. At resonance, when the cavity terminals are at a voltage maximum, when seen from the generator side, k is greater than 1, and the coupling is called as overcoupling. In this case, k is equal to rho, the SWR. Do you remember Smith chart? The normalized impedance at the voltage maximum is the standing wave ratio rho. The loaded q in terms of SWR is given by the expression as shown. Lastly, in the case of undercoupling, that is k is less than 1. Also, the terminal voltage of the cavity is maximum, giving k is equal to 1 upon rho. With this value of k, we obtain the expression for loaded q as shown. A rough graphical sketch exhibiting the relationship between k and rho is as shown. Friends, we are familiar with the term electrical circuit and network and the related terminology. We can have similar concepts while dealing with microwave devices and components. What do we understand by the term microwave circuit? An assembly of microwave devices connected to each other so as to achieve the transmission of microwave signal in the desired way may be called as a microwave circuit. The term hybrid can be associated to include the possibility of microwave devices of different types in the circuit assembly. The interconnection of two or more than two microwave devices can be regarded as a microwave junction. Some of the commonly used microwave junctions or microwave hybrids are as shown. In the module on circuit and field theory, we have discussed in brief about the concept of black box and the methods of analysis of a two-port electrical network. Consider, for example, a two-port device with only two input terminals and two output terminals as shown. Device can be modeled, that is described mathematically, in terms of several types of parameters such as H, Y, Z, T, A, B, C, D parameters, etc. The values of each of these parameters can be determined in terms of measurements of total voltages and total currents externally at the input and output ports of the device under their open or short circuit conditions. As an example, let us have a look at the H parameters of the two-port network. Slide number 60. The determination of the hybrid parameter H11 needs the measurement of voltage V1 and current I1 at the input terminal of the device with the output port is short circuited. On the other hand, determination of the hybrid parameter H12 needs the measurement of voltages V1 and V2 at the input and output terminals of the device with the input port open circuited. We may revise our knowledge about the definitions of other parameters. This approach of describing the two-port network in terms of parameters such as H, Y, T, Z, etc. works for lower frequencies. However, at microwave frequencies, these parameters cannot be determined for several reasons. Out of these, one of the reasons is related with availability of suitable equipment. The equipment for measurement of total voltage and total current at the input and output ports of the device at microwave frequencies may not be available. Secondly, the guarantee of achieving a perfect short circuit and open circuit condition. The short circuit and open circuit conditions of the input and output ports of the device or network are difficult to achieve at the microwave frequencies. Lastly, presence of unstable device in a two-port device. The device condition is supposed to be undisturbed, that is stable during measurement of voltages and currents under the short circuit and open circuit conditions of the port. Some devices such as tunnel diode or power transistor do not have stability for short circuit and open circuit conditions of the port. Thus, at microwave frequencies, the conventional parameters are of no use for characterization of modeling two-port devices. We have to think for some new approach. In the new approach, new types of parameters known as scattering parameters, designated by letter S, are used for characterization of two-port microwave devices and circuits. Determination of S parameters use measurement of power association with the traveling waves instead of total voltage and total current as logical variables. In the literature, S parameters of various dimensions and related devices can be found to be described. However, we will restrict our discussion only at an introductory level in the case of some simple microwave devices. Observe the representation of two-port network in terms of S parameters. The mathematical relations for the S parameters of the two-port network are as shown. Here, A1 and A2 represent the power incident, while B1 and B2 represent the power reflected at the respective ports of the two terminal device. S parameters are represented in matrix form and obey the rules of matrix algebra. Let us see some important points about S parameters. The letter S stands for scattering. The meaning of the term scattering in connection with optical communication, RF engineering, transmission line, etc., has different relevance and must be noted properly. It is interesting to know about the history of S parameters. The physicist and the engineer Robert Henry Decay coined the term scattering matrix in 1947 during wartime during his work on radar. In principle, S parameters are applicable at any frequency. However, they are mostly used for networks operating at RF and microwave frequencies, wherein signal power and energy considerations are more easily quantified than currents and voltages. S parameters change with frequency, hence it is essential to specify frequency for any S parameter measurement. S parameters in general are useful in various branches of electrical engineering, such as electronics, communication system design, especially for microwave engineering, etc. They are useful in representation and analysis of various types of microwave devices and hybrid circuits. Many electrical properties of networks of components, just like inductors, capacitors, resistors, etc., can be expressed using S parameters. S parameters are used to estimate many quantities associated with the ports of the network, such as real and complex linear gain, insertion loss, voltage standing wave ratio, reflection coefficient, amplifier stability, input and output return loss, reflection coefficient, and many other quantities. The analysis based on S parameters many a times uses match loads as terminations, which are much easier to use at higher signal frequencies than open circuit and short circuit terminations. We have dealt with S parameters of a two-port network. Can we have one-port S parameters? The answer is yes. The S parameter for a one-port network is simply a 1x1 matrix. It simply implies the presence of a passive load in the one-port network. Dear friends, one can go on listing many such interesting points about S parameters. However, due to time limitations, let us have a stop here. Well, friends, as a summary, we may remember some important points. The very first point is that microwave cavities can store electromagnetic energy at a particular frequency called as resonant frequency. Resonant frequency depends upon the geometrical parameters, the values of mode numbers m and n and some other quantities. Maximum energy can be stored when the resonant frequency is equal to the applied frequency. The quality factor of a microwave cavity depends upon the coupling constant when the cavity is connected to the generator. The two-port network can be analyzed in terms of S parameters, which are called as scattering parameters. In scattering parameters, we have to measure the amplitudes of the incident and reflected waves at the input and output terminals of the network. Thank you.